In the past 6 months since I owned this low pro backpack, it has been on countless trips in different weather conditions. So in this video, I want to show you how it has been wearing it for longer hikes and how big the bag actually is, what gear fits in, how well it protects the gear and where the backpack fits, and most importantly, how the weather conditions affect this backpack, such as rain, sun, and heat. As always, there are time codes below in the description for each section, so you can easily navigate in the video structure. Let's start with the overall look of it. There are two versions, the black and the gray one. And also there is the pro version and the no pro version of it. I own the gray pro version and personally love the rectangular form of it as it just allows me to fit so much gear in. If you want to know about the backpack in detail and comparison with the non-pro version, check out the other video I made about it. Few of you have been asking to show the size of this backpack on my body. I'm around 6 feet tall and the backpack feels very nicely on my back. I didn't find it too huge and it's definitely not too small. My girlfriend, who is roughly 5'4", also has no objections of its size and carries it without any problems. In longer hikes, I also close this hip belt and it does sort of help, but I wish it would be a little lower so that it sits on my hips. Unfortunately, it is not detachable, but since these flaps are very light, it doesn't bother me too much. Speaking of weight, when looking for a backpack, I was surprised to see how heavy all of them are, and I find this one extremely light for the size, amount of padding, and the build quality it has. Besides, the backpack itself can carry a lot of weight, and more about that in the next section. First of all, I must say that the bottom part of the backpack is very well padded, and I have never been worried about my gear being damaged in any way. Also, the laptop sleeve is well padded, and the laptop hangs in the cradle so it won't hit the ground. The top part is less padded, and it's for the reason, since it's meant to store your food, clothes, and other non-fragile stuff. Despite all of this padding, there is ton of space for your gear in the bag. Since I already covered what gear fits in the backpack in the previous video, let's look at the outside, what fits on the outside. There are not many options, however, the tripod actually can go into two places. Here on the bottom, which I don't find too convenient, and my favorite place, here on the side. It also comes with a little strap to secure it in place. Alternatively, you can put a water bottle here if you don't use the tripod. I did a real outdoor test of this backpack, putting it in the mud and old tree stumps on wet grass and a lot of other places. Gear is safe and the backpack can be easily cleaned with wet wipes if it gets dirty. The bag complies with all my known airline company carry-on baggage policies, and of course it fits in the plane's storage above. The only thing you need to worry about is the weight, because this backpack can carry some real heavy stuff. The heaviest I've loaded it was more than 10 kilos. Carrying it with such weight is alright, but getting it on your back, not always the easiest task. And finally, how it copes with the outdoor elements, I must say, surprisingly well. Backpack comes with the rain cover, but to be honest, I've never used it, even in the rain like this, if you can see how much it was raining. I didn't use the cover to properly test its capabilities. And it didn't soak through any water, because the material, especially on the bottom, is water repellent and feels almost waterproof. This material also helps to get any mud or dust off of it very easily. Overall, I'm extremely satisfied with the build quality, the choice of materials, the heavy padding, and all the smart pockets for sunglasses, laptops, the top compartment, and much, much more. Also, all of the buckles and zippers open and close easily, especially the zippers. They are big, the hooks are easy to grab, and they just roll so smoothly. I think I've praised this backpack a lot, but that's because I really love it and enjoy using it every day. And I know that it is not the cheapest backpack out there, but knowing that my gear is safe in any conditions or transport is truly priceless. Let me know if you have any questions about this backpack. I'll do my best to reply to all your comments. And as always, guys, I'm off to making yet another video. Cheers! There's almost no coffee left. Sad.